In this video, we are going to start our 12th project of this whole session and the second project of today, which is news scraper. What we are going to do here is we'll be going to our website, which contains a lot of news. We'll be going there, we'll be gathering the news title and also the link to the news, and we'll be storing that in our data set, which we can use for anything we want. So let's see what are the steps we are going to follow. First of all, I'll have to open the browser. So after opening the browser, for each of these pages, what we need to do, we need to go to the page. First of all, as you know that each of these pages has different URLs. So for each of the page, I'll have to generate a URL and I'll have to go to that URL. Then from there, I'll have to gather the title, the news title, and then gather the news, which is nothing but the link of that news that I am talking about here. After that, I'll have to store the data. We need to store the data in a CSV file, as we have been doing in our previous. So for each of the pages, this particular part is the same. So I'm just copying it from here. So I'll be pasting it over there. But what is happening, for different page number, the link is being changed. So I'll have to append the page number over here. But one problem is there. I is becoming 0, 1, 2, but the page number in this link is 1, 2, and 3. That means instead of concatenating I, I'll have to concatenate I plus 1 of the news. So that means I need to find this particular table. Now this table is stored with a class name item list. Okay. From there, what I need to do, I simply need to go to the titles. Now, as this title is stored here inside an A element, here the class of this A element is stored in. So the text here, the text is what stored in between the opening and closing of a tag. So here the title of the news is stored as the text here, and the href of this particular element is the link to that particular element here. So the first thing I need to do is soup.find. Now what this function does, when whatever I give here as attribute, that will be found out. Okay, so first of all goes the name of the element. The first element that I'm interested in is table. After that, here goes the information about the attribute through which I'm going to find this particular element. So here for the key name, I write the name of the attribute here. For this table, I'll have the information of the class, so I'll be writing class and then a colon, and then goes the value of this particular attribute for which I want to find this table. So I'll have to go back to this page and I'll be simply copying the class name from here. This is item list. Okay, so I'm just copying it from here, coming back to my program and pasting it here. Now this will be holding the table over there. Now what I need to do, I need to find all the A elements there, right? For that, I'm going to use this function find underscore of. After this, what I need to do, again, I'll have to follow the same syntax over here to find the A element. First of all, goes the name of the element, then goes one comma. After that, we need to give the attribute information in the form of a dictionary with just a single information over there. The key name here also, I'm looking for a class. So I'm writing class over here, and after colon goes the value for which I'm looking. So I just come back here and the value here is story name. So I'm just copying it from my. Now what I need to do, I need to extract the links as well. For that, I have to extract one value of one of the attributes of this A element. We have already done this. I need to write here j.get, and here I need to give the name of the attribute for which I want to extract the value. Okay, here I want to extract the value, whatever value is stored inside this href, that is why I'm giving this href, and just name it link. Let me save this. Let me go back to CMD, open this and run this program once again. So I'm simply writing Python and nw.py, which is the name of the file, and I'm running this. So it is asking me for the number of pages. I entered 2 and it should give me the data frame now. Yeah, so this is how they are returning me the data frame. First of all, one column is the news title, another column is there called URL. We also have one column which is not a column actually, it is the link, the index of all the data present in the do that. Now what I need to do, df.to_csv is the function that is going to help me over here. Inside this, I need to give the path. So let's just save it in the same path as we do users. Shweta, let's name it news.cs. I'll save this once again. I'll go to CMD And from here, I'll call this, I'll run this function, the program once again. Enter the number of pages. Let's skip 3 this time. So it is doing the task. It printed me the data frame, and now it is printed out done. That means this file has been saved in the location that I mentioned. You can see the in the data frame there are 90 rows because I did 3 pages, so the row became 90 and the columns are going to be 2 only. So let me just go to the location here and check whether this file has been saved or not. So I just come to this place, then users, then Shweta, and there must be a file with the name news. So let me just search for it. Yeah, news. So this is there. Now let me just open this. So yeah, so this is opening up here, and here you can see there are 2 columns. The first one is news title, which is holding the title of the news, and the second one is the column with name URL, which is holding the URL of the news.